Most of the time, when a great game comes out, everybody is talking about it, they're playing it, and it's a big hit. That's part of the hype with video games. But sometimes, there are some amazing games that just never get noticed by mainstream, and they end up flying under the radar, and then, eventually, sadly, being forgotten. What's up, guys? Jimmy here. Welcome to Chaos Top 10s, and today, we're going to be checking out 10 amazing games that no one has really ever heard of. Now, for this list, we will be looking at games that got great reviews or had a passionate following, but never sold very well during their release window. Now keep in mind, some of these games ended up getting more attention years after they came out, but at the time of release, they flew completely under the radar despite their greatness. We are running a $200 Amazon gift card giveaway the entire month. All you have to do to enter is like this video, be subscribed, turn on your notifications, and leave a comment why you want to win it with your Twitter handle attached. I will announce the winner at the end of the month on Twitter. Kicking off our list today is a game that I do not think I've ever mentioned on a top 10. Binary Domain, and this is a sci-fi third-person shooter from 2012. That was pretty hyped, but it unfortunately failed to catch people's attention when it finally came out. The story was set in Tokyo in the year 2080 after global warming had caused much of the planet to actually be wiped out, and it forced artificial intelligence to take over much of the workforce since humans were becoming scarce and unable to handle the environment, which, of course, led to conflicts between the two life forms. Now, Binary Domain also featured some very unique and innovative gameplay mechanics, like a consequence system that had your teammates change their attitude towards you depending on the actions they saw that you performed, it'd be good or bad. The game got solid reviews and was advertised pretty heavily, but it was a commercial failure, only selling 20,000 copies, as many wrote it off as just another sci-fi shooter. Now, whenever you have movie tie-in games or video game tie-in to movies, it usually doesn't go well, okay? At number 9, we have Conan, and released in 2007, it was developed by Nihilistic Software and published by THQ for the Xbox 360 and the PS3. The game was an over-the-top hack and slash in the same style as a God of War, although this similarity ultimately led to its financial downfall. You played as the legendary Conan the Barbarian as you ripped through enemies and learned various magical abilities to help you blast through your foes. And the game featured plenty of blood, gore, sex, just like the God of War series. But because of all the similarities, the title was written off as a God of War clone, and it failed to turn a profit despite the decent reviews from critics and gamers. And it did not help the game that it was so full of gore and sex that it became targeted by the National Institute of Media and Family. They claim that it was worse than any other M-rated game and never should be bought by parents, which, of course, only added to the negative attention the game was already getting. At number 8, we have Shadows of the Damned. Released in 2011, Shadows of the Damned was developed by Grasshopper Manufacturer and published by fan favorite EA. It's an over-the-top comedic action game that has since been growing a cult following, and according to reports, Shadow of the Damned started development in 2005 as a survival horror game for the PS3, with Resident Evil creator Shin Mikami running the show. But over time, it shifted into a third-person action game, and after 6 years of development hell, the game was finally released with tons of violent, profanity, sex jokes, hilarious action game stereotypes, although the creator stated in an interview that he didn't like the game at all. Despite its fun gameplay and funny writing, Shadows of the Damned was a massive flop, only selling 24,000 copies at release, which, that's really, really bad. At number 7, we have a game called Deadhead Fred. Speaking of funny horror-themed games, next up is this PSP exclusive from 2007. You heard me right. This was a PSP exclusive, and that's probably the main reason why it's on this list and it performed so poorly. Developed by Vicious Cycle Software, you played as an investigator with no head, who had to put together various crimes by gaining powers from various severed heads. The game's writing was praised as it was a parody of the 1940s noir movies, and it was filled with great humor that made up for the lack of great gameplay. In fact, Deadhead Fred was one of the first video games to ever win an award from the Writers Guild of America. Unfortunately, the game didn't sell very well. Awards don't correlate into sales, I guess, both due to the lack of good marketing and the fact that it was a PSP exclusive. At number 6, we have Alpha Protocol. This is a That's just a hardcore name, right? It was developed by Obsidian Entertainment, the same team that brought us Fallout New Vegas, and published by Sega. It was an action RPG that had you playing as a rogue U.S. agent trying to figure out various conspiracies in order to prevent an all-out war, I guess. The game featured tons of different paths to take, both in the gameplay and the stories. You could play through it with violence and flashy combat, or you could go through it as a stealth game, and the narrative would change depending on the choices that you, the player, made. Despite the awesome concept and the solid writing, the game got extremely mixed reviews upon release, with some critics praising it and calling it a fantastic game, and others calling it a poorly executed RPG that wasn't anything special. Ouch. This polarized critical response led to Alpha Protocol getting largely forgotten in the moment, and the planned sequel was canceled by Sega, although it later developed a cult following. Cracking into the top 5 today, if you're a fan of really creepy takes on children's stories, you should definitely give this game a playthrough. I'm talking about American McGee's Alice. It was developed by Rogue Entertainment and published by your fan favorite EA in the year 2000. The story is an unofficial sequel to Lewis Carroll's Alice in the Wonderland novels and features psychological horror elements and a third-person action platforming gameplay. You play as an older Alice this time as she returns to Wonderland and finds it truly disturbed and twisted, as Alice's mind has become corrupted through her life following the death of her family. It is then up to you to try to find a way out while saving Wonderland in the process. The graphics and the artwork were very ahead of their time. The game garnered a cult following pretty much instantly, although the sales weren't very good. A sequel called Alice Madness Returns was also released in 2011. I bet most of you have probably never heard of that one either. At number 4, we have Warhammer 40K Space Marine. When you think of the Warhammer series, you probably don't think of a violent third-person shooter, and that's inevitably what led to this game's demise. For those that don't know, Warhammer started as a tabletop game in 1987, then became a series of strategy games that garnered a large following for the solid gameplay and the intriguing huge universe. In 2011, THQ released Warhammer 40K Space Marine, which was developed by Relic Entertainment, and it served as a spin-off to the main series, adding some depth and backstory to various races. The gameplay was pretty interesting and featured heavy emphasis on melee combat, despite it actually being a third-person shooter, but the game was a financial flop due to THQ trying to market a shooter to an audience of strategy game fans. It didn't work, and the financial loss eventually contributed to THQ going bankrupt. At number 3, we have a game called The Operative, No One Lives Forever. That sounds like a James Bond movie, right? Released in 2000 for the PC, this game is a very cool comedic first-person shooter that was actually inspired by various spy movies from the 60s and 70s, leading to many calling it the closest thing we'll ever get to an Austin Powers video game. While the gameplay was reportedly based on games like Metal Gear Solid, GoldenEye, and Castle Wolfenstein, the story and humor was heavily influenced by the original Pink Panther movies and the various Bond films, leading to a game that wasn't quite a parody, but still a very funny and stylistic spy game. The game got great reviews and won multiple awards, but failed to perform well financially, and after 2 years on the market, it only sold 350,000 copies, which, that's a respectable amount, but not nearly as much as it actually deserved. If you're a fan of Austin Powers movies, or just old-school spy movies in general, definitely go check out The Operative No One Lives Forever. At number 2, I Have No Mouth, and I Must Scream. Yeah. That's not me telling you that, that's the name of the video game. This point-and-click adventure game was released for the PC all the way back in 95, and it was based on Harry and Ellison's short story of the same name, telling the story of an evil computer that wiped out all of human existence. Sounds like Terminator, but saved 5 people so he could torture them forever. The computer then decides to test the 5 survivors by having them try to prove that humans are better than machines. You play as each one of these 5 humans and discover each of their fatal flaws and attempt to pass the test. The game was critically acclaimed for being an extremely disturbing and well-written story that tackled topics that few other games at the time actually dared to try, as well as testing the player's morality and ethical decisions, and it is considered to be one of the best horror games ever made, despite the praise though. The game's subject matter and limited advertising ended up leading to flopping in the sales department. And finally, this one's a sad, sad case to me. At number 1 today, 007 Agent Under Fire. And many consider this to be the second best 007 game behind only GoldenEye, but because GoldenEye is so legendary, this game often gets forgotten despite its greatness. Agent Under Fire was developed by Visceral Games, RIP Visceral. It was not based on any existing 007 movie or book. The game featured an original Bond story and featured very cool gameplay with tons of weapons and gadgets for you to use, allowing you to go through the levels silently or guns blazing if you chose. And it featured a local multiplayer that some even had said it was better than GoldenEye. I'm not going to go that far at all. The game sold over 4 million copies, making it the best-selling game of the list. But despite the solid reviews, despite those sales, it seems that no one remembers Agent Under Fire. Why is that? Because it came after GoldenEye. And there you have it, my friends. Those are 10 amazing games that I'm going to take a guess and just guess that you haven't heard of all of those. Let me know some of those in there you've actually played and some that you never heard of, and maybe you're going to go give a try. There's also a playlist below with all the other gaming top 10s. A brand new one goes up every single night. If you guys enjoyed, drop a like and subscribe on your way out, and I'll see you tomorrow night for a new one.